We're in the endgame now, ladies and gentlemen. Super Mario Maker 2 is quickly approaching. We've got a lot to talk about in today's episode, so hit that subscribe button and let's dive into it. So I took 10 days away on holiday, and while I was away, my uncle that works at Nintendo said that we won't be getting any Super Mario Maker news whatsoever, so it's safe to go on holiday. I get off the plane, turn my phone on, we've got 5 images, we've got a trailer, we've got so much to talk about. The first thing that we want to have a look at is this image right here. Now you can see at the very top we've got some pins. Now I'm thinking that they're going to be pinned icons, so that when you're selecting different things that they stay where they are. So they're going to be commonly used icons. Maybe you can assign them to a button as well for fast placement of items. The next thing I want to draw your attention to, on the left hand side, right next to the camera icon, you can see ghosted out, you can see a little squiggly line. Now that looks like it's replacing the other icon that we had in the first trailer. So that's going to be controlling the camera up and down scrolling. As we move further around, we've got a blue piranha plant. We're not seeing the blue ones yet, we've only seen purple. So that's again another thing new. Now maybe they work differently to the purple ones, maybe they just stay out and they don't come back in. The next thing that I'm wanting to talk about is the little hand icon that you can see there, totally different to Super Mario Maker. In Super Mario Maker you had basically a stylus and a pen held by a hand, by Mario's glove hand, cat paw, different things like that, and you can see that it's got a little pointer and a little crosshair on it. Now you can also see it's outlined in red. Maybe this could be the sign of a two-player co-op build mode, whether that's online or whether that's local co-op build mode. I think that'd be really good if you had a red and a green icon and you could both put elements into the level. That would make for some chaos. Now the next thing we're going to be looking at is this flyer here that's come from Japan. Now the first image that we're going to be looking at is Super Mario World in the forest theme. Now you can see that we've got the sprite work there of Mario. Now in the original Super Mario Maker, when Mario was in that sprite form, we'd have an overlay of a CRT TV. So that's gone. You've still got the sprite there of Mario, so maybe that's a costume confirmed for Super Mario World theme. That'd be interesting to see the updated graphics on the sprite work. Now we've also got the water going up and down and the snake block at the top. There's nothing really new in this screenshot, but it's a really interesting one to see. Now as we move across onto another Super Mario World theme, you can see that we've got like a sky theme going on here. We've got cloud blocks, we've got rainbow blocks, we've got these weird looking Goombas. They're not Galoombas, they're not Goombas, they're sort of a weird new enemy that we've never seen before, so I'm wondering what they are all about. The rainbow blocks, they look like semi-solid platforms to me, maybe only one high. The way that you've got the mushroom blocks at the moment, you maybe could have the rainbow blocks doing the same sort of thing. You can also see that we've got red, we've got green, we've got blue, and we've got yellow pipes. Now there's something interesting that I want to talk about with pipes a little bit later on, so we'll save that for later. But it's good to see all the different colour pipes there. You can see Rocky Wrench coming out of them, and as well as that you can see the little cloud guys blowing the wind up. You can see it's blowing the bomb up as well. That's a really neat sort of addition to Super Mario Maker 2 that we're excited for. You can also see just to the right of the cloud blocks, and to the left of the cloud box, you've got like a vine sort of block, and that just looks like another platforming block, the same way that you've got semi-solids and things like that. Maybe you can shake them, or maybe you can click on them and it'll give you a different look to the level. The third picture that I want to draw your attention the third picture that I want to draw your attention to is the Super Mario, New Super Mario Bros. U theme. Now you can see you've got the propeller hat on. It looks like Mario's in a swimming animation there, but it could also be midway into a triple jump. You've got the lava, that looks like it's higher than it should be on a Bowser Castle stage, so maybe the lava goes up and down. You can also see that it's got the same background, it's got like the nighttime space theme, and in the original trailer we had like a purple goo instead of lava, so maybe we've got in sort of changeable backgrounds here, who knows, that'd be a good thing to see. You can also see that we've got the lava bubble in the clown car, and it looks a bit janky, it looks like it's clipping through the clown car, it looks a bit horrible that. I'm surprised that no one sort of spoke about that or pointed it out. Maybe everyone's looking at things with rose-tinted spectacles and we're all sort of ignoring the bad bits. The next picture that we've got to discuss is this one here with the claw.
Claw is our master. Claw chooses who will go and who will stay.
This is ludicrous.
Now you can see there's five claws.
Decided to climb into this.
The claw. It moves.
Looks like they're all moving on a track. You can see that they've got a bit of momentum and they're swinging. They're not all straight down. So they're going to act as the same way that chain chomps do, and they're going to swing back and toe. Now you can see that one's opened. It's dropping the spiky guy down. Now you can see the little picture, the little face on the claws.
I have been chosen. Farewell, my friends. I go on to a better place.
You can see how it's sort of got teeth like a smile, and it's got a straight line as a smile when it's opened. So maybe they work in the same way that thwomps do, that when you get underneath them, they open and they drop whatever's underneath. Another thing to note, we've got a few more things here. The piranha plant is upside down, mounted on the block. A lot of people have spotted that. Now, I'm really interested to see what other enemies that you can put upside down. You get a lot of munchers upside down in the ROM hacks and things like that, so it'd be good if you could get munchers or all sorts of different enemies mounted on the underneath of blocks and objects. Another thing to note here is that you've got the fireballs coming towards you, and they seem to be different sizes. Now maybe you can toggle the different sizes of the fireballs, or maybe they're just in a different size because of the where they are in the animation. But you can see you've got the three piranha plants on the right hand side. Now they're not all equal spacing, so not all one block spaced. So you can see you've got two together, and then you've got like a half block, and then you've got another piranha plant. Maybe one of them's dropped off from the claws, or maybe you can place piranha plants or goombas or anything like that in half tiles. That would be really interesting. You get some really unique setups there, especially for the Kaizo community. You're going to have some real real interesting setups for different tricks and things. Really exciting stuff. Let's move on to the next one. And then finally, on the picture side of things, we've got this one. The Super Mario 3D World theme. We've got what looks like Blarg coming up. We've got two of them. I can't remember the name of the enemy in Super Mario 3D World. I can't remember what the name is. Let me know down in the comments section. We've got Cat Bowser on the right hand side. Maybe that's a standard Bowser for this theme, or maybe the way that you can put mushrooms on Bowser in Super Mario Maker at the moment, maybe you could put the bell power up and that'll turn him into a cat. Really interesting, that theme. Again, we've got the spikes coming down from the top. They look like they're going to be falling when Mario's underneath. Maybe they are, maybe they aren't. Really a lot of details there, a lot of information. Hope you're as excited as I am for this. Let's move on to the trailer.
Bye.
Alright, here we go guys, so the trailer starts off in the Super Mario Bros. Theme. Nothing out of the ordinary straight away. We've got the pipes, and then all of a sudden there, we've got gold pipes. So, you can see that we've got the different coloured pipes in more than just Super Mario World theme. We move on, we've got the hidden blocks, we've got the star, and we take out some enemies, and then we go up the pipe. Nothing really out of the ordinary there, there's everything that you can see there, you can do in Super Mario Maker. But then, as soon as we come out the pipe, we go onto the, I don't know what you'd call it, it's not an airship theme, maybe a sky theme. And you've got the clouds surrounding the level. And then on the right hand side we've got the little, I can't think of the name of the enemy. The little cloud guy that pushes you up. Let me know again down in the comments section. I'm butchering all the enemy names in this video. So as soon as Mario jumps, you can hear straight away we've got that iconic Super Mario World music. I'm wondering, can you change level music? Can you just have a library of music and you can put whichever theme song you want over your levels? That'd be a really neat addition. I'd love to see something like that. Mario jumps up through the semi-solids, spin jumps, lands on the coins, and then all hell breaks loose. We've got POWs flashing. We've got a P-switch that was flashing. What does that mean? I'm thinking that the POWs and the P-switch, the flashing, means that they're activated, they're on a timer, and they're going to detonate. I think that the flashing will get quicker and quicker and quicker, and then they'll detonate. That's my opinion. I'm thinking that's what's going to happen. I'd love to see something like that. It makes some really, really interesting one-screen puzzles. You all know that I'm really into the puzzles. So I'm hoping, fingers crossed, that that's what they'll be with the POWs. Because they look awful. They really do. They look annoying. And I think if they're just sort of activated POWs and activated P-switches, we can live with that. But if they're the sort of animation for them as standard, it's going to get really annoying and really ugly very, very quickly. Mario goes through the yellow pipe, comes out in Super Mario 3D World. Straight away, the Goomba on the left hand side sees Mario and starts going towards him. So you can see that the large Goombas aggroing against Mario straight away. You can see that from about 3.5, 4 blocks away. So that's maybe the activation range for the Goombas. That'd be really interesting. That'd be a really cool feature. I can see some of the Kaizo levels featuring that on the new tech that's going to come. You can also see that we've got clouds going up and down. Now, I'm guessing that they're going to be the same way that you've got the platforms going up and down. There's going to be no problems there, no changes, anything like that. Mario slides down, gets the bell, does the dive, goes through the pipe. Now, the interesting thing here is as he goes through the pipe, you can see that the blooper was aggroing against Mario, so Mario can be spotted inside the pipe. Hits the donut block, goes down, goes through. Now you can see the red pipe spitting lava bubbles is doing it quicker. So we can see there that the different coloured pipes change the rate of firing, change the rate that they give you items. That's a really interesting thing. You can see on this one, as we go past the power, the two POWs and the P-switch, they're not flashing. So maybe my theory is, again, like we said, that they're activated POWs. A lot of enemies. We've got the retracting purple creeper, piranha creeper, and then we hit the flagpole, dance around the top of the flagpole, camera zooms in, and we get the little dance. Great stuff. There's loads going on there in Super Mario Maker 2 trailer. That was posted on Instagram, on Nintendo Japan's Instagram. Really interesting there. Let me know down in the comments section what you thought. I've had some really good feedback lately on the last videos, so it's been great to get all the comments and interact with you guys. It's really good to get discussions going and things like that. I'm really hyped for Super Mario Maker 2. If you're not a subscriber, make sure you hit the subscribe button for more Mario Maker content. As always, guys, take care.